it, on top of me, like, really liking Mandarin, I wasn't, again, Guy Pearce didn't really do it for me, you know. I love Guy Pearce, he's awesome, but I didn't think, like, his motives, he didn't really have, his motives were very vague, and I didn't think he was as menacing as Mandarin.
Yeah, definitely.
But then again, Mandarin didn't exist, so he didn't showcase as much, you know, evilness as Mandarin.
That's true, but that's because Mandarin was supposed to be like the exaggerated guy to strike fear into everyone. So I think that's the reason. I feel like Guy Pearce's character is kind of like Sam Rockwell's character in the second movie, done right to make him an actual threat and not just a goof.
I just like they took the biggest Iron Man villain and said, "Oh, he's fake. We're gonna get someone who's not as big, and he's the real villain now." And that just kind of like got my nerves. I mean, yeah. I still liked the movie quite a bit.
I love the movie.
I just didn't think that was. It was ballsy, but
for a movie like this, like when the twist happened, I was like, no, this is terrible. Even though I kind of knew it was gonna happen, I didn't know that he was gonna be British like he actually is in real life. And at first, I'm like, wait, what? I'm sure everyone was like, what? What's going on?
Mm-hmm.
But the movie was leading up so well, and when it got to that point, it was just like a halt. It was like, oh, the twist. Oh, okay, I didn't know where the movie was gonna go from there, but the movie managed to keep me on board, and everything that happened after that, it felt like a half-hour battle, even if it wasn't. After that,
there's the plane scene.
The movie was amazing, so I kind of forgot about the twist. But yeah, I was able to roll with it. Now, looking back, maybe they should have kept the Mandarin in. I don't know. I like that they did something different. But maybe if I was a comic book fan, or a comic book fan of Iron Man, I might have a completely different opinion.
Yeah, and just for the record, I'm not like I haven't really read any Iron Man specific comics. Like, I've read the Avengers stuff, but
yeah.
So I'm not. I don't really care too much about the Mandarin.
Some people are saying it was a good conclusion to the Iron Man trilogy. If it was a conclusion, if it was the last one, they kind of leave it open a little bit. Like, they don't completely wrap it up like the Dark Knight Rises did.
No.
No. But I mean, like he doesn't need the. He doesn't need the circle to be Iron Man.
The arc reactor.
I thought it was a good movie.
Yeah, I don't know.
Not a good conclusion.
I didn't think it had to be a good conclusion, because the thing about Marvel is it always gets bigger. So I didn't need a conclusion. I just wanted a good Iron Man adventure. I think this one delivered that. Like, it was. I thought it was a great adventure for like a little single Marvel movie, as opposed to like a big Avengers type movie.
That's a good point. To give overall statements on the movie, just for me. I liked the movie, it was entertaining, it was witty and funny, and the action was all pretty satisfying, but, you know, the villains and that whole spiel was only so compelling that I can't say I really loved it. It was still, like, a fine and entertaining movie, though.
So do you guys think that there should be an Iron Man 4 before we go into the Avengers 2?
No, that was
bad. I don't think, with all the stuff that happened at, like, the last, what was that, like, even, like, the last 5 minutes that all happened,
exactly
I say, he blew up, like, every single one of his suits was destroyed.
No, that means nothing, though, because
he could remake all that stuff.
I know that, but.
No, I'm just saying, if they really wanted to make an Iron Man 4, they're not gonna be like, oh, no, man, he blew up the suits.
No, I know, but I'm saying
it's not like the determining factor that will like change everything.
No, not at all.
I have another question. Who do you prefer in the role of Rhodey? Is that his name?
Terrence
Howard or Don Cheadle?
Don Cheadle.
I totally disagree.
I say Terrence Howard in the first, as opposed to Don Cheadle in the second.
I like Don Cheadle in his newest one a lot more.
Me too.
I still think Terrence Howard just brought so much charisma. And I thought he was hilarious.
Yeah, I feel like he had more of a personality in the first movie.
Yeah. I like the scene where he's drunk on the plane.
I just want to talk about, like, the tone of the movie. It was, like I said, it was really different than I expected. It was funnier than I think any of the other movies.
Yes.
And it had like, more effective drama, I feel like, with his, like, post-traumatic stress and stuff like that.
Anxiety.
And I think they had the best action, too. I'd say it's my favorite of the three, but I think Iron Man, the first one, is still the best of the three as far as the quality of the movie goes. But this one took more risks.
I prefer the first one, but I still really liked it. I liked this one. The tone, as I said, I thought was... I wasn't totally surprised by it because I had heard going in that the trailers were very misleading, that there's a lot of humor. It wasn't all that dark.
Yeah, no.
It felt like a Marvel movie. Which, I gotta say...
Felt like a Disney movie.
A Christmas Story.
That was funny.
One thing that I thought would bother the crap out of me when I saw this movie was the fact that, you know... This is an Iron Man movie taking place right after the Avengers. And it just, at first I was like, okay, why is it just Iron Man again? Why aren't the Avengers coming back? It gave a good reason for that, and I liked that.
Yeah, it was like...
What was the reason, anyways?
Because he's, you know, he has anxiety with the whole New York thing. And I thought that was pretty reasonable.
And also it was like his struggle.
It made sense for all this to happen. And I thought they would ignore that, but they really didn't.
I'm gonna say I'm gonna say that it's mega cool.
Okay.
Cool. So that's my rating.
Can I go like a quarter?
No.
Sure.
No.
Okay. I'm gonna go 4.
Okay.
I will between a 4 or 3.5. I don't know yet.
Is Avengers 5?
What?
I thought you were going to give it a 4.25 because your original rating was a 4.5.
When I saw it again, I didn't like it as much. But
I'm going to give it a 3.5.
I'll give it a 4.5. Whoa,
whoa. I'm going to watch it again. And then
I'm going to watch it again, too.
I guess.
Hopefully it's a 5 after that.
I'm going to watch it again.
Because I feel like it didn't feel right, you know. I think I was expecting a little bit... I was expecting something differently in terms of scale, so I'm going to watch it again, but I'm still going to go 3.5.
All right, well, really quick, let's talk about the future of the Marvel Universe. Mark, you go. You take the reins.
All right, I want to see what they're going to do with Robert Downey Jr. That's the biggest thing, because there's literally two ways they can go. I know I said earlier, I don't think Marvel will mind. I think a lot of people won't mind if he doesn't come back because it's cheap for another...
Yeah, it was like, even though it's set, even though he... basically is not Iron Man anymore. You know, he's gonna return anyways, just because. I think that would be cheap, like you said.
No, I mean cheap as in cheap to pay another no name actor to be Iron Man.
Oh no way, no.
Could you imagine like you pay Iron Man less than Thor and Nick Fury and Hawkeye?
That would be really weird.
Or what if you just, like, decrease the payment of Hawkeye and Nick Fury, because you're like, Iron Man's getting paid less, you should get paid less, too. Like, Iron Man, The Avengers 2 could be a pretty cheap movie in terms of casting if Robert Downey Jr. doesn't come back.
Maybe the last Spider-Man.
Yeah, I think I said this last podcast when we filmed a part of this. If they kill off, if they decide to go the killing route, I don't think they will.
I think they will.
If they do... I think War Machine comes in with the dramatic music, like da 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 da, gets revenge.
And he's like, I'm
shoots everyone, shoots everyone, and then I hope they don't have an after credit scene where Tony Stark opens up his eyes. That would be stupid.
Well, I don't want Tony Stark to die at all. I think he should be like a consultant, like a technology consultant, like build a suit for War Machine and stuff like that. And he could be like the Iron Man of the Avengers, but Tony Stark will still be like the cool Tony Stark. He can just hang out at S.H.I.E.L.D. with all the other guys.
Yeah. I don't know if like, he could retire and then bring in, like, actually, if he retires, then you bring in Spider-Man. Because when you get to that point where Iron Man's not in the movie, all the fanboys go like, oh, I'm not going to watch The Avengers 3, I'm not going to watch it. That's BS. You're definitely going to watch The Avengers 3.
If Robert Downey Jr. ain't in there, like, no.
Robbie, you see, like, every movie of all time. Robbie, you're definitely going to watch The Avengers.
You saw inappropriate comedy.
Maybe Joss Whedon does a...
Did you guys hear the news that Thanos is actually not going to be the villain in Avengers 2? It's going to be saving it for 3?
Yeah.
I didn't hear that.
I did.
I think Thanos will still pop up.
Yeah, I think he's gonna have a presence.
It could be really funny if, like, Robert Downey Jr. retires. Like, I mean, like, Tony Stark retires in the movie.
And then what?
I don't know, like, he just drives away and he's like, see ya!
Hey guys, I'm not gonna see you ever again. Bye.
I think he should be, like, a consultant with S.H.I.E.L.D., like, working with S.H.I.E.L.D., developing the technology for the Avengers. In the comics, he does stuff like he made a shield for Captain America that like has magnetic stuff, so the shield always comes back for him. He does stuff like that. So instead of being all the action, he could just be behind the scenes and he could still crack jokes and still be the great Tony Stark, but just not be in the Iron Man suit per se.
You know what? I like that idea.
Thank you.
There's a problem about that.
What's that?
Robert Downey Jr. Is gonna be like, wait, what? I'm just saying that so you could offer me like, you know, another $10 million maybe.
Nah.
Let's say he doesn't.
Hilarious, but so like.
No, that's what he would do. He would definitely say no, I'm not coming back, so that he gets offered another. Because like, what's another $50 million to Robert Downey Jr.?
A lot.
A few new cars. Maybe his own real Iron Man suit.
No, why does he need like? How big is his garage?
The size of my cat.
If he says no for the Avengers 2, do you go with Eric's idea? Do you send money to Eric's house and take his idea?
Yeah, that's my idea. You can't take
Disney
that model.
Disney wouldn't do that because they stole someone's idea for Finding Dory. Even though that's like something obvious, like that's not really a big idea. Do you recast Tony Stark to be behind the scenes, like cracking jokes, or do you just kill him off?
I didn't say recast. I say still get Robert Downey Jr. to do it.
No, but I'm saying what if that's not an option? What if you can't bring?
I think that is. That's always an option because Robert Downey Jr. is Tony Stark, and you can see how much fun he has interacting with the fans and stuff.
He doesn't want it to be a chore. He said.
For who? For Marvel or for him?
No, for him because he's getting older and like.
Yeah, so a chore would be like waking up at 5 in the morning and getting into the suit and stuff. That's not going to be a chore if he's just hanging around cracking jokes at S.H.I.E.L.D. It's different.
I don't think it would make sense for him to be killed off if he wasn't going to be Iron Man, you know?
No, like completely, no, not at all.
And that's just kind of like getting him off our back, off our chest.
Don't touch me.
I won't. Yeah, I think Robert Downey Jr., it said he's coming back for at least Avengers 2. So I think he's the consultant at S.H.I.E.L.D. and War Machine takes over for the action part of Iron Man. So it's kind of like split into two people.
Is he going to be a big part in Guardians of the Galaxy?
Iron Man?
Yeah.
Not at all. It's going to be all in space and he's not going to be there.
You know what? There's rumors that there was a leak a few months before and I got this spoiled for me. I just get too much stuff spoiled for me, but you know what? It happens.
Don't spoil it for us. Oh, when he goes into space?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, with, like, little toy and stuff. I think that would have been cooler than what actually happened. That was kind of, like, a little... That was, like, a shawarma-esque scene.
Yeah,
they had two scenes in the Avengers, so...
I feel like Marvel goes the funny route now that Disney's on board, than the awesome, you know, let's promote the next movie. I mean, like... You know, they want money for the next movie, but they're going to get it. They don't have to advertise it in Iron Man 3.
Yeah. Thor 2 is probably going to have something, though.
Even if he's not in it, I will still be looking forward to it. But honestly, Robert Downey Jr. is really what makes Iron Man what it is.
You could get someone that acts exactly like him.
No.
Yeah, you can.
You can, but don't. You can,
but
don't.
It wouldn't be as fun.
They should have done that for Terrence Howard. They didn't have to, like... I think they recasted... Rhodey, as if it was a reboot, they're like, okay, we should make it more black. They've been thinking of this ever since the first one came out, or even before. Like, if you're making a big movie like this, you could fanboy out. If they're like us, maybe. They're just sitting around the table thinking, what do we do for 3 and 4 and 5? I don't know where they're going to stop.